Yes, okay.
We have to do all, so we are going to start and move forward in the PNF techniques that we have already been discussed. We have discussed few techniques. Today we are going to see another technique. So last thing that we discussed was the difference between the stabilizing reversal and the rhythmic stabilization. Moving forward to repeated stretch. Now repeated stretch means you are going to give stretching at the end of the at the beginning of the motion or within the motions, wherever it is applicable. So it can either be at the beginning of the range or it can be throughout the range. If I like to demonstrate and give you overview of what it is simply nothing else but giving stretching. Say for example, I want to provide stretching to biceps muscle. My elbow flexors are weak, elbow extension is weaker. So I want to start with elbow flexion. Yes. So what will I do? Whenever the patient, we are giving three commands, more importantly. First is always preparatory command. You prepare the patient that what they are supposed to do. Yes, say for example, for elbow flexion, I want to prepare. So I'll ask the patient to now be prepared to move the elbow into flexion or be ready to bend the elbow. Second is action command. That is, you are going to tell the patient to actually perform it. And third, if they are doing anything wrong, you will provide corrective command. Yes. So while we are giving preparatory command, we can provide the stretching. So whenever you are telling the patient is here, okay, so okay, now be prepared, we are going to provide stretching or we are going to do some activity. So at the starting position, the patient will have elbow into complete extension and then you are going to go for flexion, that is action of biceps. So in the starting, whenever the therapist will be either standing where the patient is sitting or lying supine down. Starting में आपने stretch provide कर सको, biceps will move the elbow into extension, that will stretch the biceps along with of course the biceps are two joint muscles, so we are also going to see if the shoulder is neutral or extended and provide the stretching there. Yes, so we can provide stretching at the beginning of the range. Starting में आपने stretching provide कर सको, and then ask the patient immediately, तरत stretching पूरा था है, तो immediately ask the patient to perform action. Yes, action. Perform karwani, go throughout the range and go for movement. Yes, so that is first way. You can stretch at the beginning of the range. Also, you can stretch within the range multiple times. That is, say for example, extension se, you go for extension, that is elbow flexion mein aap strengthen karwa che. So stretching through directly stretch also. And then in the middle of the range, you go again for stretching. Patients who kare che, elbow flex karwani try kare che. At the same time, you are providing such a force, elbow extension ma jai, and then stretch na lide pachu contraction na. Why do we need to give stretching? Stretching works on simple principle of stretch reflex. Yes, an input from the sensory fibers to interneuron, this we have discussed so many times. From interneuron, alpha motor neurons will be excited, will provide the signal to the muscle to contract. Yes, the biceps weak che, contract nahi kari sakte, to aap isko try kar sakte. GTO and spindle, muscle spindle, they sense the, you can say, speed and range of contraction of the muscle. Yes, range khabar pad sake bahut vadhare nahi thato ne bahut vadhare thase to pan activate karse interneuron ne alpha motor neuron will lead to muscle contraction, the forceful contraction thase vadhare saru contraction thase, that is the primary need. Also we are going to see about say for example speed. If you are doing it very fast, then also the GTO will sense it, send the signal to alpha motor neuron through the interneuron and there will be muscle contraction. So both ways, what are we actually planning? We are moving for more forceful contraction through stretching, that is stretch reflex. Yes, that is the main aim of providing this technique. So both are the important techniques we remember. It can either be given at the beginning of the range or it can be given throughout the range. What is the characteristics of this technique? So, from the beginning of the range, first of all, yes, we are going to talk first of all about the beginning of the range. So, the stress reflex elicited from the muscles under the tension of elongation, only muscle should be under tension, take care not to stretch the joint structures. So, what does this mean? We are trying to move the biceps. In our example, we are trying to move the biceps into extension. Yes, elbow extension, that means stretching. But the tension should be only as much in extension it looks for one to be just structure damage in our head. Most often we are going to see, we are going to apply PMF specifically for neurological conditions. In this, the patient does not have much voluntary control. Patient bully kyoi kai tension karan. We have discussed this in last lectures, yes? So similarly, when the patient does not remember how to do action, will not remember how to inhibit actions also. So your stretching force should not exceed certain maximum level. Yes, normal individual na tumhe ekdam extension kari aapko, he will be able to reflexly contract. But patient who has lost voluntary control will not be able to control the motion, and maybe you might lead to dislocation or injury of the other portion like capsule or ligament of that joint. So this is the stretching from the beginning of the range. Yes, and go extension kari aur then forceful contraction. It can be in any for any muscle or it can be in pattern also. Yes, whenever we are talking about pattern, so starting kari, starting thi, wrist, fingers extension, elbow extension and shoulder ne, extensions ne ek sathe stretch kari sakaya yathi and bench contraction apne start kari sakaya. That is all possible. It can be either muscle wise or it can be also pattern wise. What is the goal? Why do we do it? So facilitate initiation of motion. Why? Because it is a stretch reflex. Reflex does not require voluntary motion. Reflex itle ki je automatic phase karu na pade. So a reflex through apne initiate karav so patient ne. Patient pehla jo se kai rite thai che ane pachi try karse karvani. Brain remembers motion, not the muscle action. Yes, so motion jo se feel karse, proprioceptive inputs avse and nothing voluntarily kari sakse. Increase active range of motion. Active range of motion. Difference between active range of motion and passive range of motion. As the name suggests, active, એટલે કે patient જાતે કરી શકે. Passive means we can do it. Passive range of motion for normal healthy individual will always be full. May that be shoulder, may that be elbow. Yes, 150 degree of flexion extension at elbow, 180 degree of flexion extension at shoulder range. Yes, so all this will be passive range of motion. આપણે કરીએ તો full થાય. But what happens is active range of motion decreases. Active motion, active range of motion decreases thai, એટલે કે patient જાતે voluntarily નથી કરી શકતો. Yes, that means there is muscle weakness. If there is muscle weakness, we go for this. And through the reflex mechanism again, it can induce more and more forceful, better muscle contraction. And because of this muscle contraction, there will be more amount of active range of motion. Passive to full hase, yes. Tamara muscle paralyzed thai jaye, koi pan to passive range change na thai, but active range change thai jaye. Increase the strength, as we talked about directly, it is a reflex, the same mechanism as we are discussing from now. Prevent or reduce fatigue, because fatigue is overuse. Yes, overuse. When we are trying to move a muscle multiple times, our capacity 5 times new, if 5 times new biceps curl kari sako, pachi na kari sako with 10 kg. If I start doing more, what is caused is called as fatigue, the feeling of tiredness, that is fatigue. હવે ના લઈ આવું હોય તો શું કરાય બાયસેપ્સ ની જગ્યાએ ટ્રાઇસેપ્સ ને સ્ટ્રેચ કરો એ સાથે તો ટ્રાઇસેપ કોન્ટ્રેક્ટ થશે ફોર્સફુલી તો બાયસેપ્સ રિલેક્સ થશે લો ઓફ રેસિપ્રોકલ ઇનહિબિશન યસ સો ઇટ પ્લેઝ અ ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ રોલ ઇન પ્રિવેન્ટિંગ ફટીગ ઓલસો ગાઈડ મોશન ઇન ધ ડિઝાયર્ડ ડિરેક્શન જે મોશન માં તમારે ડિઝાયર્ડ ડિરેક્શન માં મૂવમેન્ટ જોઈએ છે એ જ મસલ તમે કોન્ટ્રેક્ટ કરશો સે ફોર એક્ઝામ્પલ પેશન્ટ અલોંગ વિથ એલ્બો ફ્લેક્શન ઇઝ ડુઇંગ ઇન્ટરનલ રોટેશન યસ તો તમે ખાલી એલ્બો એક્સટેન્ડ કરશો ઓર એલ્બો ફ્લેક્સર્સ ને સ્ટ્રેચ કરશો તો શું થશે ઇન્ટરનલ રોટેશન થી ઓછું થવા માંડશે યસ યોર હેન્ડ વિલ ગાઈડ ધ મોશન ધેટ ઇઝ વાય ઇટ વિલ ગાઈડ ધ મોશન ઇન ધ ડિઝાયર્ડ ડિરેક્શન એન્ડ નોટ ગોઈંગ ઇન ટુ ધ રોંગ ડિરેક્શન from the characteristics, from the goals directly we can say indications. First is weakness, because the patient we want to facilitate initial range of motion. Inability to initiate motion due to weakness or rigidity, weakness or rigidity. Rigidity is again UMNL, UMN, that is upper motor neuron type of lesion. Yes, spinal cord level thi upar kyan pan injury thase, inter neuron ni upar kyan pan injury thase, ene kevay upper motor neuron lesion. Yes, if the patient is having this type of symptoms, it will either be spasticity or rigidity. Yes, both of these are hypertonia, that is increased amount of muscle tension. Muscle tension, right now it is normal. Yes, I am moving my hand normally. When I am palpating, when I am doing it passively, I can feel some amount of tension. Yes, e vadhi jai, e sutam vadhi jai, because alpha motor neurons vadhare excite karva mande muscles. Yes, and hence there will either be spasticity or rigidity. What is the difference between spasticity and rigidity? You will learn in fourth semester. We'll discuss more detail about coordination, balance, and at that time we'll be discussing more in detail about spasticity and rigidity. Overall, just remember there will be hypertonia, increased tone. Yes, but hypertonia, tone increase thai, that does not mean ke muscle vadhare strength vadu chhe. Hypertonic pathological muscles are always weak muscles. जिम में जाने तो मैं बाइसेप्स बनाओ, पेक्टोरल्स बनाओ, ट्राइसेप्स बनाओ, ऑल थिंग्स आर हाइपरटोनिया, एमा पर टोन बदे, बट दैट इज नॉर्मल फिजियोलॉजिकल. तुम रोज एक्सरसाइज करी नहीं बनाओ छो, दैट इज व्हाई इट इज फिजियोलॉजिकल एंड दैट मसल्स आर स्ट्रांग. बट इन पेशेंट बिकॉज ऑफ एनी पेथोलॉजी मसल टोन इंक्रीज થઈ જાય છે, મસલ ટોન ઇન્ક્રીઝ થઈ જશે, એના લીધે ધ પેશન્ટ વિલ હેવ વીક મસલ્સ, નોટ સ્ટ્રોંગ મસલ્સ. યસ, બીકોઝ ધ પેશન્ટ હેઝ નોટ વર્કડ ટુ ગેઇન હાઇપરટોનિયા, ઇટ ઇઝ પેથોલોજિકલ. Disease na lide uchu. Yes, and decreased awareness of the motion. Yes, so if the patient is not knowing how it is done, say for example a brain example like you bicep flexion with internal rotation sath thatu hoy, the patient does not know how the motion is to be performed, at that time we can guide it through repeated stretch at the beginning of the beginning. Contraindications, these are also the contraindications of overall stretching. Yes, stretching mein ke contraindications hai, same joint instability. Yes, if joint there is subluxation at that time or ligament injuries, this will all lead to dislocation in the future if you try to stretch. Barabar joint ma elbow ma stability nahi hai, tumhe extend karo excessively to sun thase, joint will come out of its normal position, that is dislocation or subluxation. Unstable bones due to fracture or osteoporosis. Osteoporosis is decreased bone density. Density is mass by volume. So the bone loses the capacity to hold the calcium ions. Yes, calcium ion bone ma ki blood ma khamde badhai, and so the bone becomes weak. If the bone is weak and you try to, you know, you can try even to sneeze at that time, cheek khase patient cough karse to pan fracture thai jaye, etlu weak thai jaye. Yes, so at that time if you provide stretching to sun khase katta thai jase. Yes, you will cause the fracture, in pathological fracture. So if there is a fracture or severe osteoporosis at that time, this is not supposed to be given. Take this in mind. Most of the patients, when you are going to see, as of the condition we talk about stroke or hemiplegia, hemiparesis, half side is weak, half of the body is completely weak. Yes, at that time they will be having higher age. Higher age of osteoporosis is common. So look for the sign if the patient is complaining of bone pain, if they are complaining of poor upper limb pain, do not give stretching. Stretching from absolute to some say directly you will cause the fracture. And fracture thing to say, that part will be immobilized. Ek to paralyzed che mine m name rakhvan. Yes, to muscle to zero, atrophy thing is damaged muscle or tendon. Yes, so all any structures, ligament, muscle or tendons near a joint, if they are involved, at that time 100% you will have to leave that and do not give stretching. These are the contraindications of stretching in the bone. Description. How will we start? What preparatory commands do we need to give? What are the things we already performed? So the same things we will try to understand while giving commands. This is again reminding you, this is just the first portion. Repeated steps from beginning of the range. We have just started from the range. Yes. Starting of the range, we are trying to provide and then provide the movement. The therapist gives a preparatory command with fully elongating the muscle in pattern. Pay particular attention to rotation. Rotational activities are always excessive activities. જ્યારે પણ તમે કહેશો ને પેશન્ટ ને કે એલ્બો ફ્લેક્શન કરો તો એબડક્શન સાથે ઇન્ટરનલ રોટેશન સાથે આવી જશે. યસ ઇટ ઇઝ વોટ વી ટર્મડ ઇન લાસ્ટ લેક્ચર્સ ટર્મડ એઝ સિનર્જી. એબનોર્મલ મૂવમેન્ટ પેટર્ન. યસ સો ધેટ ઇઝ સિનર્જી. સિનર્જી કમ્સ ઇન ટુ એક્શન ઇન પેથોલોજિકલ કન્ડિશન્સ. ગિવ અ ક્વિક ટેપ ટુ લેન્ધન ધ મસલ ફર્ધર એન્ડ ઇન્વોક ધ સ્ટ્રેચ રિફ્લેક્સ. એટલે કે અહીંયા આપણે સ્ટાર્ટ કરી છે, પ્રિપેરેટરી કમાન્ડ આપી દીધું, હવે તમારે વાળવાનું છે. યસ એન્ડ ધેન યુ આર અગેન પ્રોવાઇડિંગ ધ સ્ટ્રેચ ફોર ધ બાયસેપ્સ મસલ. At the same time, give a command to the patient link the voluntary effort to the reflex. And હવે ત્યારે તમે તરત જ્યારે સ્ટિમ્યુલસ આપી દીધું એન્ડ રિસ્પોન્સ ઇઝ અબાઉટ ટુ કમ, રિફ્લેક્સ જ્યારે આવવાનું છે, ઇટ ઇઝ ઇન માઇક્રો સેકન્ડ્સ. યસ અ રિફ્લેક્સ વિલ હેપન ઇન 0.01 સેકન્ડ. યસ તમે સ્ટિમ્યુલેટ કરશો, વિધિન ધીસ ટાઈમ ધેર વિલ બી અ રિસ્પોન્સ. યસ તો આની વચ્ચે તમારે કમાન્ડ આપવાનું છે. This is very precise. That is why the basic principle of timing plays a very important role. So, resist the resulting reflex and voluntary muscle contraction. જ્યારે તમે આ કમાન્ડ આપશો ઓફ ધ મૂવમેન્ટ, એક્શન કમાન્ડ છે, ત્રણ કમાન્ડ છે, પ્રિપેરેટરી, એક્શન એન્ડ કરેક્ટિવ કમાન્ડ. સો પ્રિપેરેટરી આપી દીધું કે આપણે હાથ વાળવાનું છે. નેક્સ્ટ કમાન્ડ વી આર ગોઈંગ ટુ પ્રોવાઈડ ઇઝ નાવ યુ હેવ ટુ બેન્ડ, ડુ ઇટ નાવ. યસ સો રિફ્લેક્સ નો સ્ટ્રેચ આપ્યો તમે એન્ડ નાવ યુ આર આસ્કિંગ અ પેશન્ટ ટુ move it as much as possible, and then you are trying to resist the resulting reflex and voluntary muscle contraction. Example, lower limb flexion, abduction, internal rotation. Yes, D1. Place the foot in plantar flexion and inversion. Rotate the patient's lower limb into external rotation and then into full extension, abduction and external rotation. So this is the complete movement of D1. If you don't remember, that is fine. You can even write the example in your words. That is completely normal and fine. Yes. That was from beginning of the range. Give expected preparatory command. Okay. So when you feel the patient's muscle contract, give resistance to the entire pattern. જ્યારે પણ તમે પેટર્ન માં સ્ટાર્ટ કરો, સે ફોર એક્ઝામ્પલ લોઅર લિમ યુ વોન્ટ ટુ સ્ટાર્ટ, ફ્લેક્શન, એબડક્શન એન્ડ ઇન્ટરનલ રોટેશન યુ આર ગોઈંગ ટુ સ્ટાર્ટ, એન્ડ ફ્રોમ ધેટ યુ આર ગોઈંગ ફોર એક્સટેન્શન, એબડક્શન એન્ડ ઇન્ટરનલ રોટેશન. સો એટ ધેટ, સોરી, એક્સટર્નલ રોટેશન. સો એટ ધેટ ટાઈમ કમ્પ્લીટલી થ્રુ આઉટ ધ રેન્જ યુ કેન પ્રોવાઈડ, બટ હિયર ફર્સ્ટ ઓફ ઓલ વી આર ટોકિંગ અબાઉટ ઇનિશિયલ રેન્જ. સો ઇનિશિયલ રેન્જ યુ પ્રોવાઈડ ધ સ્ટ્રેચ and then move the limb into complete opposite action of what the name of the pattern is, because that is the end range always. Coming to the second, repeated stretch. Yes, so if you see the reflex pattern and the graph shown for the first and compared to second, we are doing it throughout the range of motion. So for first, what we were doing, we were just trying to get from initial range. Initially, patient therapist extend karine, we'll try to move the part as much as possible, and of course we'll resist throughout the range of motion. In this, performing throughout the range of motion, so preparatory command api didu, action command pan api devanu, have karu. Yes, when they start doing it, at that time you are going to provide extension and provide the stretching. Yes, in the middle of the range, patient will always try to move the part into flexion. You have to resist as much. ધક્કો મારીને પેશન્ટના હાથને ઓર એલ્બોને એક્સટેન્ડ કરવાનું છે. યસ એન્ડ અગેન ડુ ઇટ, અગેન ડુ ઇટ, અગેન ડુ ઇટ. પેશન્ટ ફ્લેક્સ જ કરે છે. યસ માય ધીસ હેન્ડ ઇઝ પેશન્ટ્સ હેન્ડ, ધીસ વિલ ઓલવેઝ ટ્રાય ટુ મૂવ ઇન ટુ ફ્લેક્શન, ધીસ વિલ નોટ એક્સટેન્ડ. પણ સામે હું એટલો જોર કરું છું થ્રુ માય રાઈટ હેન્ડ વિચ ઇઝ થેરાપિસ્ટ હેન્ડ, that the hand moves into extension and there is stretching. Stretching of the biceps within contraction while it is contracting. So you can see preparatory command, then go for direct voluntary action. This is voluntary action. Patient courage jata hai. Then again you are providing the stretching. Pachu voluntary, pachu stretching. Pachu voluntary. Yes, and you can provide up to 2 to 5 times in between. Yes, depending on which range you want to improve. Goals in we'll talk about the stretch reflex elicited from muscles under the tension of contraction. Why? The muscle is being contracted. At that time, if you provide the stretching, that is termed as repeated stretch throughout the range. Goals: increase active range of motion, increase the strength, prevent or reduce the fatigue and line of motion in the desired direction. Again, same things that we have discussed for initial ranges, the same should be applied and will be applied for the goals of the throughout the range of motion stretching. Indications: weakness, fatigue, and decreased awareness of desired motion. Again, the same things. Contraindication: same joint instability, pain here will be there. Why? Because the muscle is contracting. If muscle is contraction and you try to move it or elongate it, that is stretch it, then it may cause pain. And if the patient is complaining of excessive pain, there are again, in stretching we have described two types of pain. One is stretch pain and one is pathological pain. Patient will be able to feel it. Yes, tumhe apne stretching aapta hoi, tumhe pan stretch karo. Yes, at that time the pain that you feel, that is stretch pain. But because of the disease, some other kind of pain is there, that is termed as pathological pain. If there is pathological pain, you should not give stretching exercise or stretching through PLF techniques. Unstable bone and damaged muscle or tendon, at that time also you are not going to provide stretching. The therapist resists the pattern, so all the muscles are contracting and tension. You can start with an initial stretch reflex, give preparatory command, at the same time you slightly elongate the muscle by momentarily giving too much resistance. If we give starting non-resistance also, and later on when the movement has started, we provide more resistance to stretch the muscle, more resistance again to stretch the muscle. A new and stronger muscle contraction is asked for and resisted. The stretch reflex is repeated. The patient must be allowed to move before the next stretch is given. The patient must not relax or reverse the direction during the stretch. There are stretching happening, see, there are patient voluntarily trying to move. That means they will be voluntarily contracting. At that time you are providing the stretch, like you are relaxed. The patient must not relax. Nahi relax while you are providing the stretch, contraction example, lower limb flexion, abduction, internal rotation, resist the patient moving his or her lower extremity into flexion, abduction, internal rotation, foot up, pull your leg up and up, the same commands that we have already used to describe the lower limb, PLF patterns. Give a preparatory command, slightly over resist the motion so that you can pull the patient's leg for short distance back in the direction of extension, abduction and external rotation, the starting position. Patient must maintain the contraction of the stretched muscles. Give the command, pull again harder immediately after a stretch. Give appropriate resistance to the increased contraction. Repeat the stretch and resistance. A rule of thumb is 3 to 4 stretches during one pattern. Ideally, you can give up to 2 to 5, but 3 to 4 is more ideal. Pranthi charva during a contraction. Yes, this is starting of contraction. 1, 2, 3, 4, and completing that. Yes, so 3 to 4 stretches are more ideal. The only difference between both the techniques that we discussed today is in this, either giving it in the starting of the range or either giving it at the throughout the range. That is the only difference between both the techniques. So that is about the stretching techniques we give. And the same thing, PNF stretches that we talk about is this, repeated stretches. Yes, so that helps us to understand more of the motions that we are going to provide during stretching for an individual who requires PNF. But in stretching, we have only one indication. The main difference, why we are discussing this alone. For stretching, stretching, aapko jab aapne bhani kiya, ema ek ka indication hai to, that was tightness of muscle. If there is tightness, you provide stretching. If there is no tightness, you do not provide stretching. That was the only indication. But here, in PNF, you You can also provide to tightened muscle. You can also give to a patient who is having increased muscle tone. You can also provide for decreased voluntary control or weak muscle. All this can be benefited from PNF stretching. Yes, so that is why we do not discuss stretching, that is PNF stretching, in the normal stretching overall. Then we are discussing about the types of stretching. Yes, normal, static, dynamic, ballistic, PNF, cyclic, all the stretching that we discussed, they were all part of, only indicated when tightness of muscle is involved. But PNF can be given for multiple things, specifically in neurological conditions. Yes, next techniques that we are going to see in furthermore classes, they are more based on specifically ortho. Yes, their names are simple. We have discussed them also. Contract and relax and hold and relax. Yes, what are they? We are going to see in the next lecture and probably next two more lectures, and we complete the PNF as a whole. Yes, including these are the practicals that we are performing. That is why I have chosen to record this, even my video, so as to you can remember everything. I'll be uploading the same to YouTube, so it will be easier for you to understand and go through it even after few days or even months. Yes, okay, fine. Okay, any doubts regarding what we have discussed today, please reply to me with yes or no in the chat, everyone.
What is the difference between synergy and trig moment?
Synergy and trig moment, very nice question. If I have to evaluate synergy and if I have to evaluate trig moment, there are two major differences that you can easily find. Synergy is always, remember this, synergy is always present when there is involvement of brain. Trig moment will always be there when some anatomical structure is involved. Specifically, when a muscle has lost its function. Yes, so say for example, initial 15 to 20 degree abduction is done by which muscle? Which muscle is responsible for initial motion, abduction? Yes, please. Which muscle is responsible for initial 15 degrees of shoulder abduction? Yes, I'm not able to hear you. Can you repeat?
Supraspinatus.
Very true. But supraspinatus is paralyzed or is injured in any form. What will happen? The patient will not be able to do abduction. Yes? If the patient. Okay. If the patient is not able to do abduction at that time, what will be the condition? What will he do? He will try to laterally bend and cause momentum. Yes, so he will do this way. Yes, why? Because initial 15 degree possible nothing, and it is against gravity. Yes, against gravity the hand has to move. But what will he do? He'll move into lateral flexion. So 15 degrees clear now, and now the deltoid can work and bring the hand into abduction. So that is one of the trick movements. So it is always related to anatomical structure. Here the brain is involved. Yes. Otherwise, there is no difference, or you can say synergy is an abnormal pattern. Pattern means it will remain throughout the range of motion. Trick movement will not be throughout the range of motion. Abduction nahi tha to and function se nahi tha. Any over comparing, let's say, for normal feature separation. Yes, so say for example, biceps is paralyzed. Yes, so coracobrachialis and brachioradialis, what they will do, they will not allow the hand to be pronated and moved into flexion, shoulder flexion and elbow flexion. So patients who can say, deltoid ki try karine, this will be the momentum that they will gain. Yes, but additionally, koi motion, rotation, nothing for do. But in synergy, it will be throughout the range of motion and other components, specifically range of motion of rotation will be involved somewhere or the other. Yes, so rotation is one of the components that will be added to synergy patterns, and free movements will never be involved. Whatever the structure is involved, if a muscle involved, each directly in a synergist has in compass. In a synergist has in each compass. In synergy, it will be related to all muscles of the joint and knee. Useful, or there will be causing the synergy. So two important things you need to learn between synergy and trick movements. Synergy is, you can say, always neurological related to brain. Trick movements, majority of the time it will be related to orthopedic conditions. Yes. Also, synergy will be present throughout the range of motion. Trick movement will only be present where the anatomical structural loss is there, not throughout the range. Yes. Abduction start karyu, pachi patient aam nahi ye, pachi patient situ thai jasa, and abduction normal thai jasa. Yes? So, this pattern cannot be corrected. Synergy inward start na erase it. One more difference if you want to add resistance. By providing resistance, synergy increases. And trick movement of assist. Yes? Trick movement sukaam nahi thai. Vaya please resist karu patient abduction karva maate and supraspinatus is already injured. So, sun kase patient movement as well. Yes, I am movement has a, but that will be synergy. So resistance is the third difference that you can understand from this difference that we have talked about between both. It was a good question. You should ask such questions frequently. Yes. I hope it's clear to you.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes. Tell me furthermore, any other doubts, any other questions you have? Okay, fine. So we'll keep it till here. In the next lecture, probably we are going to see two orthopedic conditions, how to do it, and we'll look into how to apply also hold and relax, contractless, which are again used for mostly orthopedic conditions to improve the range of motion. Yes. Okay. Have you taken the attendance?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So we'll keep it till here till Monday. Hope you have a good day. Be safe.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.